Sea of Stars is a gorgeous and heartfelt RPG from Sabotage Studios that's heavily inspired by the classics of the 16 and 32-bit eras like Chrono Trigger and Super Mario RPG. I loved everywhere the sprawling story took me over the course of my 30 hours, and despite a few small problems, it's a game that proudly sits alongside some of my absolute favorites of the genre. The adventure finds your party of magical warriors, mysterious assassins, and heroic cooks on a quest to rid the world of an ancient evil. Though the premise is familiar, the twists and turns along the way helped maintain an excellent sense of momentum, and the writing constantly impressed me with its ability to bring out a laugh one minute and a tear to my eye the next. And though it's set in the same world as Sabotage's previous game, The Messenger, no required reading is necessary to enjoy this story. Gameplay is split between exploring peaceful towns, surviving enemy-packed wilds, and solving puzzle-heavy dungeons. I'm particularly fond of the latter, as this made smart use of the various abilities you acquire throughout your adventure to overcome their challenges. And I wouldn't dare spoil it, but the story has some genuinely surprising moments and took me to places that I never expected it to. Aside from the main quest, Sea of Stars is packed with a wealth of things to do. Whether it's slowly building up a settlement from scratch, hunting for hidden rainbow shells around the world, or challenging folks to Wheels, a triple triad-esque game found in every bar you stumble into, I was always entertained. As I sailed across the world, I loved how varied each new town and dungeon were. There's a great tangibility to every area. Small things like being able to climb, drop, swim, and hookshot around the world built a strong connection between myself and the play spaces. A few hours into the game, you'll gain the ability to fluidly change the time of day, and the dynamic lighting system had me just standing there on multiple occasions and gawking at the world around me. And holy smokes, the soundtrack from Eric W. Brown with a handful of guest tracks from the legendary Yasunori Mitsuda is one that I'll be listening to outside of the game for a long time to come. This sense of place is only strengthened by the turn-based battles occurring right out in the environment where you encounter the enemies, a la Chrono Trigger. They keep you engaged thanks to timing-based enhancements to offense and defense that'll be familiar to anyone who's played any of Mario's RPGs. A new wrinkle to this formula is the lock system, where an enemy charges up a big attack over the course of a few moves, and the only way to stop it is by hitting them with a specific combo of damage types before they get a chance to strike. I loved this during boss battles, which had me managing resources, swapping party members on the fly, and constantly thinking a few moves ahead. That said, having this system in every single battle started to weigh the pace down a bit, especially when it came to backtracking through certain areas. Having to pay attention to every single encounter felt like both a blessing and a curse, as I never got that gratification of clearing a zone and revisiting it way overpowered to exact my revenge, something I love doing in games like Earthbound or Persona. That minor gripe aside, nearly everything else about Sea of Stars is of the highest quality. The compelling story, wonderful aesthetics, and constant sense of adventure kept me motivated to press on through the credits. In an era where so many games wear their classic inspirations as a badge of honor, Sea of Stars stands tall among them. Sea of Stars is available on August 29th for $34.99 on PC, Switch, PS4 and 5, the Xbox One, the Series S and X, and as a part of both Game Pass and PlayStation Plus Extra and Premium tiers.